So let's talk about what causes magnesium deficiency. So we'll draw us a line over here and type in deficiency. Number one, the number one in the U.S. diet is sugar. And what I'm talking, when I say sugar, I'm really reflecting on processed sugar. I'm not talking about natural sugars that might be found in fruits. I'm talking about processed sugar. So if it's got added sweetener, added sugar in it, understand that for every carbohydrate sugar that you eat, to break down one molecule of sugar in running it through the proper biochemistry, there are 8 different steps in that cycle. And half of those steps, more than half of those steps, actually require magnesium. And what happens when you eat processed sugar without magnesium, remember, sugar has no nutritional value. There's no magnesium in sugar. Your body has to find the magnesium from somewhere. So if you're eating foods high in sugar, your body steals that magnesium from your own storage to process that sugar and try to convert it into energy. So sugar is hands down, in my experience, the number one cause of magnesium deficiency in the U.S. What are some of the other causes? The second one is high stress. Stress depletes magnesium. Now, I'm not talking about acute stress where you have a bad day. I'm talking about chronic, prolonged stress. It's repetitive. It doesn't go away. Maybe you hate your job. Maybe you're in a bad relationship. Maybe you're taking a really stressful class in college, like whatever that might be. If that stress goes chronic, you're losing magnesium consistently. What else causes magnesium deficiency? Well, I'm going to say it, coffee. Now, there's a rumor going around the internet that coffee is this really super rich in magnesium. That's not true. Coffee's not that rich in magnesium at all. But it's not really even necessarily the coffee directly, but it's what's in the coffee, caffeine. Now, I'm not talking about the person that drinks a 6-ounce cup of coffee a day, but I'm talking about you. If you're driving through the Starbucks line or you're going into the McDonald's and you're picking up, you know, these, you know, 20-ounce cups, that's not a cup of coffee, by the way. That's about 3 cups of coffee. A cup is 6 ounces. So 1 cup of coffee, the caffeine, and that's about 100, 120 milligrams of caffeine. You'll be okay with that if that's all you're doing on a daily basis. But if you're doing these 20-ouncers, these big jugs, if you're drinking 3-4 cups a day, if you're the pot a day kind of person, the quantity of caffeine that you're consuming, know that caffeine's a diuretic that depletes magnesium at higher doses. So if you're taking in high quantities of coffee, again, large, bigger than 6 ounces. So greater than 6 ounces. Did I do that right? No. I think I'm off the board here. Greater than 6 ounces, that's when you start really getting into trouble. Now, what else can cause a magnesium deficiency? And probably the most, we'll say one of the rarest to be discussed is medicine. You know, generally you go to the doctor and you think, hey, I'm taking this medicine, my doctor gave it to me, it's going to improve my fill in the blank, my situation, right? And you know, those of you tuning into this show probably know better, but many medicines deplete magnesium. Let's go through kind of a short list, but blood pressure medications deplete magnesium. Antacid medications deplete magnesium. Some antibiotics can deplete magnesium. Some antidepressants deplete magnesium. Some anti-seizure medications can deplete magnesium. So many different medicines will cause this to happen. And ladies, for you, you should know one of the biggest, we'll just write it in here, are estrogen medicines, birth control pills, or estrogen substitutes. So I'll just put the big ones in. Hypertension, so blood pressure medicine, birth control pills, and then subsequently to that, antacids. These are really the top three that will deplete the magnesium from your body over time. So it's not if you took, for example, it's not if you took blood pressure, or not blood pressure, but an antacid last night. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the chronic use of these medications over long periods of time, over months. They start to deplete, either they deplete the nutrient itself or they inhibit your body to be able to use the nutrient, or they actually cause an excessive excretion of that nutrient. So those are some of the different mechanisms, but very, very common to see medicine deplete magnesium over time. And we'll talk a little bit in a minute. I'm going to draw you a picture because I really want you to see this. Now, there's another thing that causes magnesium deficiency that many of you suffer from, and that goes back to inflammation of the gut. So if your gut's broken, you're not absorbing very well. And where does magnesium get absorbed? It gets absorbed in the small intestine. So if your gut's on fire, if you've got an irritable or an inflammatory bowel disease like celiac disease, Crohn's or ulcerative colitis, or if you've got other kind of non-specific inflammatory diseases that you've been diagnosed with, those, you know, some people get a diagnosis of gastritis. Like, what does that mean? It means inflammation of the stomach, esophagitis, inflammation of the esophagus. You know, some of these different terms, but if you've got inflammation in your GI tract and it's hindering or affecting your body's ability to digest and absorb nutrients from the food that you eat, then you're at risk for deficiency. So this is, think of this as kind of the big list of different things that you want to know about if you're doing them, or that things that you can change about your lifestyle or behavior that might help you move in the right direction. So let's switch gears here, because I want to give you some food for thought tonight as it relates to number four. A lot of people don't realize, I'm going to give you a couple different scenarios. Let's say you've got high blood pressure. We're abbreviating that as HTN, hypertension is what that stands for. And let's say your blood pressure's up, right? And so the doctor prescribed you medicine for that, and the medicine depletes your magnesium. Goes, the higher your blood pressure gets. Now, I want to be real clear. We talked about this in past shows where one of the big factors involved with the cause of high blood pressure is actually low magnesium. Low magnesium is known to cause your blood pressure to go up. It's partly because magnesium regulates muscle tension. Now think about that for a minute. Your heart's a muscle and so are your blood vessels. And so if your blood vessels can't properly dilate and contract and dilate and contract, and they're stuck kind of in a spastic or a spasmodic position, then it's going to increase the tension or the pressure on the wall of the arteries. And that's what blood pressure elevations are. When we measure blood pressure, we're actually measuring the pressure on the arterial wall. And so if magnesium deficiency is present, it increases the pressure on that wall because it causes a vasoconstriction or a constriction of the blood vessel. So my point in saying this is, if you're on the medicine to lower your blood pressure, but the medicine causes magnesium deficiency and magnesium deficiency increases muscular tension on your vascular arterial tree, and it creates an increase in your blood pressure, what are we doing? What's the scenario? What is the outcome? Are we winning this? No, we're losing. This is a losing battle. You're not going to win here if this is the scenario, right? So you've got to figure out, you know, I always go back to what, you know, functional medicine, which is root cause resolution. You've got to figure out why the blood pressure is elevated in the first place. You can't just go after it with a medicine and expect that that medicine is somehow miraculously going to fix why your body is driving up your blood pressure in the first place. Remember, elevations in blood pressure are a symptom of a deeper problem. They're not the actual problem itself. They're a symptom of the problem. Hey, and if you missed the earlier part of this series, click right here so you can go back and get caught up. The information there might be critical to helping you on your path to better health. And as always, thanks for tuning in. Make sure you subscribe for updates below. Have a great day.